Hello my friends, welcome to my Energy Economist channel. We're going to start today by knowing the energy return on energy invested, so stay with me. Energy return on energy invested, EROEI or EROI, is a significant issue. The recently rapidly falling EROI ratio for conventional oil is confirmed by other studies that modern society needs a minimum EROI ratio of perhaps 15 to 1 from its fuel sources to function in its current. And even where EROI ratios are higher than this, being lower than in the past reduces society's overall wealth if not compensated for by productivity or efficiency gains elsewhere. Regular conventional, deep water, tar sands, etc. by the corresponding net yield ratio to turn gross barrels of production by category of oil into a corresponding forecast of net energy barrels. Because the non-conventional oils have in general lower EROI ratios than conventional oil, the overall decline in global production is steeper in net barrels terms than in gross barrels. An often overlooked aspect of EROI data is net energy rate limits. These are limits to the maximum rate that an energy producing technology can be usefully introduced, and reflect the fact that if the technology is introduced faster than the embodied energy required for a new plant, the overall net energy yield during the growth phase is negative. This is partly due to having a moderate EROI ratio, but mainly to their rapid uptake, and even where technology is introduced at a slower pace, the net energy yield can be significantly less than the energy yield as usually calculated. Most current global energy models don't take into account either EROI ratios or net energy rate limits. A major cause of confusion in oil statistics is that there is no standard definition of the boundary between the so-called conventional and unconventional oil and gas. It's clearly important to make clear distinctions because the different categories have different distributions, rate of extractions, costs, and other characteristics. The resources of non-conventional oil and gas are large, but extraction is normally difficult, costly, environmentally damaging, and above all, slow. The entry of supply from these sources in the future is clearly important, serving to ameliorate the post-peak decline. But it's doubted if they will have much impact on the date or height of the overall peak itself. If you want to learn more about the energy return on energy invested, you could do so in my book, Economics of Petroleum Principles, which is published on Amazon. Check it out at the link in the description. Please take a second to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and do not forget to also hit the notification bell. Thank you for watching and goodbye.